Everyone, this is Yop back with another episode of This Old Pin. I'm really excited about this episode because I've kind of been in the discovery process for the last couple of weeks. And what I've been working on is clear coating a play field. Now, not clear coating in the traditional manner that you would think of, someone spray painting it with a clear coat. But I ordered this piece of polycarbonate sheet from Germany for this firepower while I was restoring it. Now, this machine had really badly cupped inserts and they were very dull, so I replaced them. They're a lot brighter now, and I'm going to kind of show you this in a few minutes. But it didn't play very well. The cupped inserts would capture the ball down around the flippers up here in these lanes. The ball would make some kind of wonky movements. I've completely fixed that by covering it with this polycarbonate. And I'm going to go over some of the good and the bad with what I did here. And also, we're going to talk about the possibility of this being better than it is. I had an idea while I was doing this, and I don't know that it's been done yet. And maybe it has, but if it has, I'm unaware of it. But we're going to take this process, which the newer machines, they already have these pre-done, ready to go. They're cut, and this one did fit almost perfectly. But we're going to take this, and we're going to apply the same technique to my 1966 hotline, which I brought back, about a month ago. But we're going to change a few things. And I think it's going to make it a lot better, if not a complete replacement for the idea, at least for me, of ever doing a clear coat. So let's go over the good first, and I've kind of made some notes so I don't skip over anything. I'm not the best person on video or whatever, but I wanted to make sure I covered all the main points. So if anybody else wants to try this and they kind of know the cons and the pros of doing this. So I'm going to start with the first pro. If you're replacing your inserts, which I did here, you have a really hard time getting inserts completely flat. Yes, the guys that do it all the time, I know they're really good at it, but I did not want to use spray paint if I didn't have to. So let me, matter of fact, I'm just going to bring you down close so you can kind of see what my inserts look like. And if you will notice, they have the nice circles around them. Well, that is done. I took the old inserts and I put them on a flatbed scanner, and then I imported that into Illustrator, and I created all these in Illustrator and just printed them out. Matter of fact, you can see another sheet here. I've made a few mistakes when I was putting them on, so I made another sheet and I didn't have to use all of them. As you can see, that is a nice, clean, pretty tight graphic. The ink in these is not as good as spray paint. The light does tend to shine through it just a little bit, but at least for my purpose, it's completely acceptable. So that kind of covers the inserts. Second, remove, replace, workable. Let's say I didn't like something about this. Unlike a clear coat, if I wanted to take this sheet off, I would have to depopulate the play field, obviously, but it's not that hard. So I can take it off. Once you spray that clear coat, once you start, you're not, there's really no going back. I mean, you can sand it down, but that is not easy. Once you got this down, you've now got your play field to zero wear. The ball is not touching the play field at all, except for a couple of areas, which we're going to get to in a little bit. And that's one of the things I'm going to try to correct with this kind of new technique that I'm working on. Quiet, as a matter of fact, it's unbelievable how quiet the ball rolls on this stuff. For anybody who's never played with it, hear that? It's just about silent. I know some people probably like you know, the sound of the ball rolling across the wood. So it may be a drawback for some. For me, absolutely perfect. It does not bother me at all that the ball doesn't make any noise. To me, that says the ball's rolling good and smooth. It's not wearing the play field at all. So this is a complete, it's like an armor almost for the play field. Graphics replacement. And I don't know if you've even noticed, but the whole time that you've been looking at this play field, there's a spot right here. And if you look at it hard enough, you can see it. You can kind of see the outlines of it. There's a piece of planet that was completely worn away here. Well, I used some vinyl, brought this, I took a picture of the play field, brought it into Photoshop, used area around it to recreate this spot, and then I put that vinyl down. Now, I could have done a couple of things. Let's say I didn't have this coat of polycarbonate sheet on top of the play field. I could have gone a little deep and sanded this down so this would be completely flat, okay? It's only sticking up, I mean, just barely above the actual play field. But I could have sanded into that just a little bit and probably gotten it completely flat. But because I was putting this sheet down, it really isn't going to matter. It does not affect the ball rolling at all, okay? Zero. Before I did that, I tested it and I put the ball right there on that spot and it would actually sit. So it does not take, it doesn't, there's very little tolerance in actually keeping the ball from rolling true on a play field. And anybody who's worked on them already knows that. If you needed to replace graphics, as a matter of fact, including these stickers, all of these stickers that I used, if I rolled the ball directly down this without this on here, you would hear it go thump, 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 thump across every one of those stickers. Any kind of graphics becomes far easier when you've put down a sheet of this stuff. I would imagine, although I've never clear coated a play field, I would imagine what I did was a lot less work than trying to clear coat one of these play fields. As a matter of fact, I didn't even have to depopulate it completely. I didn't have to take some of these posts off. Most of it was depopulated, but there was still quite a bit. I didn't have to take any of this off. You know, to me, easier than clear coating. We've already kind of discussed perfect ball movement, so you can see how well the ball moves. This makes me very happy. I guess you can see how nice it looks like a clear coat. Look how shiny that is. I mean, there's no glass, so that looks really, really good. Let's go to the drawbacks, and there are some. There are a couple of drawbacks to doing this as it stands right now, and these are the two drawbacks. There's three. Dust. You can kind of see. I don't know if you can see it with this camera, but kind of see a little bit of dust. I don't think you see the dust as much when you've got just play field, even with a clear coat. Maybe you can, but I notice it a little more. Of course, I can just take a damp rag and just wipe this down and pick the dust up. So not a big deal, but you can see a bit more dust. But here was the deal breaker for me as far as this particular overlay that was basically purchased. And that is anywhere there's a rollover. If you'll notice, they had to do this kind of weird cutout where this rollover is because the ball has to be able to push down on that button. Well, that does affect the way the ball comes out of there. But even worse, on this side, the very first time after I got it put together, my son was playing. If you'll notice, I kind of had to sand this down and I had to put some part of this stuff on it to raise this up because the ball, if it's traveling slowly, as a matter of fact, it will sit right there. If it gets stuck in that spot, you are going to tilt the machine trying to get it out. It's just, this is only 1/32 of an inch thick, but that's enough. That's all it takes for the ball to get stuck in a spot like that. So here's what I plan to do. Well, let me go to the third drawback. And the third drawback is price. A sheet of this pre-cut is $120, ordered from Germany. And with shipping, it's about $140. Even with me paying that much, I plan to redo this using this other method, depending on how it works over there on the hotline.
But we're gonna go through that. I'm gonna go through the entire process, and it's gonna be more work on the hotline than it was on this, because I'm gonna have to take a lot more stuff off the playfield. We'll go into all that. I hope you guys stay tuned and see what I'm proposing to do, and we'll see. And you know, as I test, I'll know if it's gonna work. But this stuff right here, I absolutely love it. Other than that little issue right there. But that issue for me, quite frankly, is a deal breaker, because I do not want to be playing pinball, have the ball get stuck right there, can't nudge it out. I mean, I'm shaking that table pretty good. Can't nudge it out and have to pull the glass back to get the ball out. It's just not going to work for me. So anyway, I hope everyone stays tuned. I'm going to start taking this one apart. Let's go over here to the hotline. And as a matter of fact, let's take a look at this hotline. Hold on just a second. I'm going to take the glass off, and then I'm going to look at a couple of things I am going to change about this hotline. And we'll see how it kind of performs now, so we can kind of do a before and an after on the ball performance. As you can see, there is no way. Well, first of all, that company out of Germany doesn't even make the templated polycarbonate sheet for this. And even if they did, every one of these is a rollover. It would be a nightmare. Even as thin as that sheet is, if you put a ball through this area, which is right in the middle of the play field, it would bounce all over the place and it would get stuck in one of the holes. I have no doubt about it. Don't even need to test it. But I think there's a way around it, and we're going to see. But the other thing, if you'll notice, you see like this, these wear spots here? With that polycarbonate sheet, I think I'm going to be able to clean these up. Now, I don't mind. This yellow is not as bright as it used to be. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with the machine looking like it's 50 years old, because it is. But I think I can touch these up, make them look good, even with the wear that did. I mean, this machine actually looks pretty good as old as it is. Clean these up using the same method that I used with the stickers over here, which I wouldn't be able to do, I don't think, as easily with a clear coat. I'm going to do the same thing here, and let's also take a look at how the ball rolls currently with the glass off, so we can compare it when I've got this done. Okay, so let's check out how this machine currently sounds, looks, works. Obviously, there is a lot of ball sound. You can see it rolls over those. It currently rolls over these rollovers pretty smooth. I mean, yes, they stick up a little bit, but they're not. It certainly won't capture the ball. But it rolls over them. Not bad. It will affect the ball movement a little bit, but that's inherent to these type of rollovers. Nothing like if I were to put polycarbonate over this with a big gap in it. You know, maybe you could cut out this entire area and it drop off, but still you're going to have to get up over that lip back onto the polycarbonate. That's going to be a problem. So we are going to work that out. I think we can work that out. So anyway, you kind of get an idea of how well it works. Come on, A. Come on, A. I don't want the B. I want the A. Okay. So stay tuned. I'm going to start depopulating all the things that I need off of this play field, and I'll show you where I'm going with this idea. Right now I've got my son helping me depopulate the play field. We are going to take off everything that sticks above the play field. Anything that stands above the play field, even including these rails and these rollovers. If it's flat with the play field or below, it stays. So rollovers, or sorry, not rollovers, but inserts will stay. And if you'll notice, this has actually got one of those sticker things that I made. I was just kind of trying it out. I think that looks better. I had to replace these. All of these inserts are cupped as well. And the nice thing about putting the polycarbonate sheet is I'm not gonna have to replace these. I did order some of these. I want you to see the problem with new inserts. And the nice thing about being able to use, especially for the white, these whites are just so much brighter. And I even put one of these in really strong tea. I kind of sanded it down and I let it soak in a really, really strong tea for a week, and it's still way too bright. So if I could, I'm gonna polish these and I'm gonna create a new surround, the black circle around it, with one of the stickers to make it look nice. I'm gonna clean up this yellow paint. And then once they put that polycarbonate over it, it should look good. I think it'll look good. As I was saying in one of the earlier videos, we have to take out everything that is at the play field or below, including rollovers. So these are the rollovers. And I'm sure most of you who've ever worked on a play field already know how to take one of these rollovers out. You want to get a socket that is about the same size as the outer portion of the rollover. These are plastic. These are almost, you know, they're old. They're almost 50 years old. So you try to be very careful to not crack them. But I basically warm them up for about a count of 15. Okay, with just a Wagner heat gun set on low. Then I immediately, with a rubber mallet and this, just if I tap on it the first time and it doesn't come out, I'll hit it for another 15 seconds. And I put a towel down here to catch, since you've still got the electronics in. And I can also take that and clean it up while I've got it out. So all of these rollovers are going to have to come out. Yep. Ready. Thank you. This is the end of day one. I got everything on the play field that I needed to take off. Off. It's gone. What little touch-ups that I needed to do have been done, which very minor, just a couple of little chunks of paint that are gone. I touched up. And before I finish out this first night, as you can see also all of the inserts, I don't know if you can see this low, but all the inserts, not the inserts, but the rollovers have been removed. And before I finished out tonight, I wanted to kind of show you the first bit of exciting piece. And I know that I mentioned earlier in the video the pre-cut ordered piece of 1/32 of an inch polycarbonate sheet was $120 plus $20 shipping from Germany. Now, yes, that's pre-cut, but you also know about the issues we had with rollovers. And you know, not only that, but along the edges, you can see where the, you know, the edge of that polycarbonate sheet is. And while it looks, you know, you don't really notice it, but I think it can look a little better. So let me show you what I've got. A raw, uncut piece of 1/32 of an inch polycarbonate. And I ordered it online, and instead of being $120, it was $15. As a matter of fact, if you'll buy five or more sheets at once, you can get it for $11 plus shipping. And since it can be rolled up, it's shipped in a small box.
It's not like when you get a real big thick piece, because those are expensive. They get this stuff, as far as price, goes up exponentially really quickly. This is the sheet that I'm going to be using for the test. Let me just kind of show you everything. I want you to get a close-up of the... I never wanted to see a close-up of what I put on the plate, or what I took off the play field and what I left on the play field. Down here, I didn't have to take this off because I'm going to cut that piece just underneath where the apron covers. So I didn't really have to take all this out. And then I'm going to cut it to come around and come down here into the trough. I'm going to be cutting a strip, since there's extra of that. First, I'm going to test a strip. I'm going to cut a strip, and I'm going to put it right here next to the shooter, next to the plunger. And I'm going to put the heat gun over there on it. And since it is heat shapeable, this polycarbon stuff, it should settle right into that groove. If not, then if it doesn't work, it's not a big deal, because I can just start it up here somewhere and just kind of cut a V into it, so it'll just run right up onto that V, and then it'll be up on top of the sheet once it gets past this point. But I'm going to test this first. Here's all the rollovers out, and everything else that stuck above the play field. All these are still in, and the inserts, don't have to remove them. Even though this sticks up above the play field, I didn't want to take it out. I didn't want to mess with that. So I'll show you how I'm going to deal with that. That shouldn't be a big problem. The good news, as far as taking everything off, if you'll notice, everything else that is not sticking above the play field gets to stay. That's a lot less work. I don't know, I've never clear coated a play field, so I don't know if that's something you can do with all this stuff on the bottom, but I kind of have my doubts. If this works the way I think it's gonna work, then I've taken off everything that I need to. As a matter of fact, like all these switches and everything, they're just hanging underneath, not a problem. So when I'm done, I'll just slap them right back in. I've got to let this sit tonight because my back is done. It took me a few hours to get everything off the play field, of course. And tomorrow I will pick it up and go from there. Since the last video, I've rough cut in the protective sheet, and the first thing I'm going to have to do is where I mentioned these are still sticking above the play field. So I'm going to mark them off and then cut out those holes, drop it down flat, and then I'm going to start with these rails. And I watched some video on this type of covering, and one of the big complaints is that it pillows a little bit, and people feel like it slows the ball down. I don't see it, but it's one of those things, it's going to be a personal preference thing. I think even if it does slow the ball down slightly, the benefits of having it there outweigh the ball being on the play field and or having to do a clear coat, like an automotive clear coat. So I'm still running with it. But I've got to cut these out, and then I'm going to put holes in it where the rails go. And speaking of the pillowing, since this is going under the rails, hopefully it's going to hold this a little tighter in the middle. So maybe it won't pillow so bad. I don't know. But then after that, I've got to start cutting a hole in this stuff everywhere there's a hole in the play field. So that's going to take a little bit of time. So I will probably check back in on the video while I'm in the process, but that's what's going on next. I also have to trim this entire side off.
But I'm going to do that after I get the rail in. So we'll check back shortly. Let's take a look at where we are. All of the holes on the play field have now been cut out. Even these small holes where the standoffs and the bumpers and all of those things are going to go. The lanes have all been taken out. I haven't cleaned all this up yet. It's still kind of a mess. And as you'll notice, each one of these, and I just used a Dremel to cut each of these out, just being real low speed, being very slow and deliberate, so I didn't take out too much, and I didn't take out too much. You know, you take out a little bit of the wood when you do that, but once I fill these in with silicone, I'm going to use like the clear silicone to fill these in, it should look fine. I don't think it's going to be a problem. I did try the heat thing down here, and it bubbled this stuff up. I never could get it smooth, even trying to press it down into this crease. I tried just by hand to cut this. There's just no way. So what I'm going to do is take this piece off and cut along these lines. The rail, it'll still have the plastic coat underneath the rail. The two wooden rails that go on each side of the trough. I want everything to be consistent as far as the height, so everything's raised that 1/32nd of an inch. And then it'll just come to a point. While I was cutting this, the one thing I did do is after I took these, you know, I marked these with a marker and took it over, away from the table, and so I didn't mess up these two nylon. Oh, I don't know what you call them, but I didn't want to mess those up. So I took it over there, I cut it, and I made sure that I had some of these quick grip things, so this didn't move at all. And I also cut, there's a couple of, these actually stand up off of the play field as well. I went ahead and marked those so I could cut the holes for those, and then to make sure that this piece didn't move at all while I was doing all the rest of this work, I simply put these down over the top of it, and that secured it. So now as I start, I'm going to take this off. I'm going to create the new outlining circles for these, as well as the three specials. And these I did replace because, well, I didn't know I was going to do this when I was replacing these. I thought about replacing these and ended up not doing it. But when I replaced, these were cut so badly, it would always pull it, you know, it would just pull it down here, and then I think it usually ended up going this way, but I wanted it to be more random. So I know now that I've got this play field coated, it should be completely random, which is what we're shooting for. So what I'm going to do now is remove this, tighten up these few graphics here. Then I'm going to put it back down, and then the fun begins. I get to start repopulating this thing, starting right here. And if you haven't figured it out yet, which you probably have, what I'm going to do is when I put these inserts in, I've still got to clean them up. Let's see, I'm going to take one of these. Okay, so when I put these inserts in, instead of making them flush with the table, I am going to make them flush with the protective coat. So that should do a couple of things. First, this is going to be secured all the way across because it's going to have stuff holding it down all over the place. So that should cut down on it doing the whole pillowing thing that people were complaining about online. I don't know that it'll completely stop it from pillowing, but hopefully it will, you know, at least minimize it. But I'm going to mount these flush with the protective coat. That way we don't have all that issue that we saw on the firepower where the ball gets stuck. It should roll across everything smoothly. And I'll know whenever I whenever I finish this thing up. So we're getting closer. This is day two, and I don't know. I probably got, if I had to guess, about,
I don't know, 12 hours in it so far. 6 hours yesterday and 6 hours today. Maybe twice that. I don't know.
it's been a good bit of work, but we're getting there slowly but surely.
I was testing some of the switches to see if they were going to work, because these inserts that the rollover kind of sits down inside of, I had to raise them up to be flush with the top of that layer of polycarb. So when you move it up like that, the switch now no longer makes contact. And let me show you what I'm talking about.
If you look at this from the side, when it pushes down at the top, it makes the connection there. This is like a little nylon standoff that keeps it at the same level, and you can adjust it by actually bending it up here, and that kind of causes it to seesaw. But with that, it still holds this too low to really be effective, so I'm having to sand that down just a little bit to get the switch back into proper adjustment. The other thing that I run into is I ordered, and this has nothing to do with really the putting the protective coat on the play field, but I ordered some of these new rings. There was two of them that had, they were where the nut goes right here. This thread was completely broken off. So I ordered a couple of new ones, but what I didn't know is there's this extra little, the old ones don't have it. You can see here, this is just smooth all the way up to the ring. But the new ones have this extra little, I don't even know what that is, but I'll tell you what it is, it's a pain in the ass. Because when this goes down, it pushes the activator ring, the switch ring, whatever you call that, it pushes it down and it causes this to lock into place. So I'm gonna have to take this, desolder it, take it back off the play field, and either open up the small hole in this ring or shave some of this down. So that's what I'm gonna be doing this evening. And then I'm gonna be putting the rest of the rollovers in, shaving them down to get them adjusted. Start putting all the playfield plastics on. I may be able to get this done tonight. I hope so. I'm thinking I've got 3 or 4 hours maybe left in it. And if I had to guess, the total project is probably going to be in the neighborhood of 15 to 20 hours to do everything on this particular playfield. Now, one of the things about this playfield that makes it a little more difficult is all of these rollovers. That's a lot. That was a lot to mount and get flush with the top, and this is kind of a good angle to show you actually kind of how I mounted that. So that should hold, that should roll smoothly, and like I say, I'll know once I get everything put back together, and we'll check back in a little later after I've got some of these other switches put back into place. And also, I failed to mention, I got all of these stickers placed here, here, there. I also put one on the gate. This is kind of splotchy in this area, and it was mostly that way even before I started with any of the touch-up. I think once I've got the plastics in and the lights on, you may notice that a little bit, but not as much as it's noticeable right now. Especially because usually I play with the lights down and just the lighting from the table on. I don't think it'll be as noticeable, but anyway, I will probably check back in with the video after I've placed all of these rollovers and gotten the switches adjusted and have them all working, and we'll see where we're at that point. Let's take a final look at the hotline with everything back in place. I've got a ball in the trough. We've got all of the rollovers adjusted. If the ball will ever come down, I'll grab it. It's working really well. I'm very happy with how it turned out. The rollovers work really well. And all the switches up here, even no problem with the ball, even the balls going through the... I could listen to that all day. I'm going to go back and post just a few seconds of video. You kind of got to see that, how it's working now. I'm going to go back and post just a few seconds of the video from the before so we can go back to what it did look like. And then I'm going to do one night shot, and that will close out this episode of this old pin. So if anybody's considering doing this to an old EM, I say go for it. It's a little bit of work, but I think the end result is worth it, unless you just don't like the polycarbonate, which is fine as well. Some people don't like it from some of the comments I've read online, but I really do like it, and I'm kind of glad I did it to this machine. Anyway, thanks for sticking with me. I know this is kind of a long video. If you have any questions, feel free to either hit me up on Facebook or here on YouTube, although I tend to not check YouTube that often for comments. Have a great day, everybody. Obviously, there is a lot of ball sound. You can see it rolls over those